Headlights go up. Headlights go down. Headlights go up. Headlights go down. Headlights go up. Headlights go down. Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good day. Hope you are all having an amazing day today. My name is Lex, and welcome back to some more GTA 5, where today we are going to be looking at this. No, this is not a Mazda. It's not an MX-5. In fact, actually, okay, let's be honest right now. This is pretty much a Mazda MX-5. Let's be real here. However, it is badged as the Anis Kawai. This is supposed to be a lore-friendly version of the Mazda MX-5. And, yeah, this is the sort of car. It's very hard for me to try and put this across to you that this is supposed to be a lore-friendly car, because to be honest, this really just is an MX-5. There's no two ways about it. It just looks like an MX-5 that's had a proper, genuine GTA 5 interior put in, at least. But it's, yeah, I'm not really convinced. Normally when you find these cars that Rockstar have made, because these are all based on real-life cars and everything else like that, I mean, that looks like an Audi, but at the same time, it doesn't look like an Audi because there's all these things, you know, that sort of make it look a little bit different. Again, like that truck there and that car there. They're all supposed to look like something from real life, but not. Whereas this one, it's just an MX-5. But we're going to be looking at this car today because there's a bunch of tuning parts and stuff for it. So I figured even if this wasn't an MX-5, it still makes for a fun video making some cool builds. So that's what we're going to be doing today. Before all of that, though, there's going to be some comments on the screen. These are comments featured from the previous video. If you would like your comments featured, you can leave them in the comment section below. I'll pick some, not at random. I'll just pick some really good comments and leave them at the start of the next video. And don't forget, you can also follow me on Instagram. I'm trying to post a lot more to Instagram now. You can check me out, _figure8, links to my Instagram in the description below, as well as my Twitter, @figure8. That truck, whoa, that truck just completely, not just run over that deer, but bounced over that deer. Okay, this doesn't really rewind very well. And I killed that guy. That wasn't very good. And, whoa, okay, okay. I mean, yeah, this hasn't really worked out. And he's on fire for some reason. Okay, I've made a massive crash. This has all gone terribly wrong. Everything's on fire. Yeah, we're demonetized now. Let's try and find somewhere to park, and let's go and check this car out and modify it. Oh, definitely monetized now, if you weren't already. And here we are with the Anis Kawai. So we have, oh, actually, I love how this looks, especially when we zoom in, because it makes this just look so much bigger. Oh, that is so cool. I love that view. Well, we have the boot that has not much in it. And then we have the engine, which is actually 3D. This is a new 3D engine model. I don't think this is one that is actually based inside of GTA at all. But it's got a 1.6 engine badge there by Anis. And then we've got our interior, these nice simple seats. All of this is taken out of a pre-existing car from GTA 5. That's all pretty much simple. And, I mean, when you think about it that way, considering it's got the badging and it's got the right interior, yes, this does fit inside the GTA universe. But it's just one of those things where it looks so much like the original. Like, this one looks like a Mini, but there's a little bit extra. I mean, like, it doesn't look like a Mini exactly from the back. There's a little bit that sort of breaks it away from reality that this car really just doesn't have, in my opinion. Anyway, I really need to stop pointing that out, and let's just enjoy the build for what it is. So the only thing that I can really see that's different from a normal MX-5 would probably be the fact that these lights are just full yellow, because they're not normally like that. I mean, even this Anis badge looks like an old Mazda badge. That's, it looks so much like an old Mazda badge. Even these lights, I think, are slightly different, but still generally, yeah, okay, right. Let's see what sort of tuning parts we have for this then. So, let's go to menus, customs, low rider mods. We've actually got a few options here, which all seem to be related to engine stuff, but let's have a look. We've got the parcel shelf speakers that will be on the back here. Ah, okay, and that also actually makes the texture a little bit nicer as well. So I think we're going to keep that in. Then on the engine block, whoop, if we, okay, we're going to have to open this bonnet, aren't we? So on the engine block, we can go from this 1.6 to the 1.8, which basically just looks exactly the same, but that's in red, and it says 1.8 on the badge instead of 1.6. Then on the filters, which is actually the intake pipe color, we have the red intake pipe. We have then primary color option and secondary color option. Well, I'll just go with the red for that one for now, because it actually matches with the 1.8 ignition leads there. Then on the arch covers, which is actually the roof, we have the option of a roof rack, and I'm not sure that's going to go well with this build yet, so I'm not going to include that for now. And then we have the BD Sports wide body kit that actually makes a really bulbous looking wide body kit all the way around. Thank God that we have V-Stancer, because these wheels look completely lost in the arches now. I'm going to do that, but not in this first build, because I actually want to make this first build as like a, I don't know, as if I had this in real life sort of build. So to start with, we've got the spoiler and we've got a huge selection. So we've got the stock, which is nothing. We have the ducktail in primary color, secondary color, and carbon, which is a pretty nice selection there. Then we have BD Sports in primary, secondary, and actually not carbon, just primary and secondary. Then we have the Wing 6. Then we have the GT Wing. GT Wing number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. Big, massive. Oh, look at that. It just looks wrong. It looks so wrong. Then we have the Extreme. Okay, it just gets even bigger. The Extreme Street Racer Wing. Then the Drift Wing, which is actually a lot smaller. And then we have the Performance Wing. Look at the size of that. Looks like some sort of Pikes Peak race car with a massive spoiler like that, or a Time Attack car or something. Well, because I want to have this as if I had it, it would either be something like this simple... Well, it would either be nothing, or maybe... Actually, no, I'm not really fancying those as much as I thought. It would be either the ducktail or nothing, and I think I'm just going to go with the ducktail just so we can have an interesting build. Then, on the rear bumper, seems we're already here. Might as well see that first. We have the stock. We have the remove rear bumper, which is kind of weird, because it's very low texture behind as well, which, you know, it just gets rid of the whole thing. That's kind of weird. Then we have the clean rear lip kit, which basically just sort of smooths that bit down the bottom there, like that. Then we have the BD Sports rear, sort of like a drifty looking style kit, I'd say. Then we have the stock bumper with diffuser going on down the bottom. Then we have the clear lip and diffuser, and then we have the BD Performance and diffuser. I think for this one, I don't really want to go for the diffuser. I think maybe just the clean rear lip kit will do. I think that looks pretty nice, even though it's very similar to the original. Then on the skirts, we actually just have the stock or the BD skirts. We'll definitely be doing some sort of big BD kit as well with all the wide arches and stuff next. But I want to do this one first. Then onto the exhausts, we have the stock, which is actually pretty fair already. Then we have the upswept. Whoa, okay, that's pretty big. And doesn't actually have an end. That just sort of goes on for... Whoa, okay, that's weird. Look. Okay, that is a very, very weird exhaust tip. Then we have the big bore, which also seems to suffer the same weird fate. That is very strange. Then we have the titanium one. Ah, there we go, an actual exhaust this time. Ah, at least this one is nice and just pure and clean and everything. I love that one. I'm going to go for that one. Then we have the chrome roll cage in there. Then we have the option in primary color and secondary color. I'm going to actually go for a primary color. It's a shame we couldn't have just had one on the back instead of having to go for the full one, but never mind. So the first option's pretty interesting. It's the rising sun flag on the bonnet. Now, some of you might not realize this, but this flag is basically like Imperial Japan. This is the flag that was used when Japan took over Korea, like during the Nanjing Massacre and all this sort of thing. So this is like in Asia, the way that we see the swastika, the Nazi swastika flag in the West, this is sort of like a similar one, but for Chinese and Koreans and everyone else who fought against Japan in the war. So, yeah, kind of weird that this flag still seems to be used a lot. Anyway, then we have the carbon fiber bonnet. We have the smoothed hood, which is very similar. We've got that little bulge there. It just gets rid of the bulge, and then we can also have that in carbon fiber. And the carbon fiber's not too bad, but I'm going to use that for the full all-out one in a minute, so I'm just going to go for a smoothed hood for this one. Then on the engine, it's just going to be level 4, race brakes, race transmission, suspension. Slam that down. Actually gets a pretty sizable drop on this one. Let's just see how that drop happens. Pretty simple. And then the race one brings it down quite a lot. Right down the bottom there. And then in extras, we have nothing. So it's just going to be a case of turbo, and wheels and playing around with V-Stancer, I guess, and paints. And actually, as I'm going through this and realizing that we do have the orange indicators, I want to go for a blue, because I think blue with the orange indicators is always an awesome look. And instantly, I just love this blue because of that orange. We don't normally go for blue on this channel. Blue's pretty much one of these colors that is rarely done on builds. But that's not too bad. Actually, racing blue's pretty nice as well. I'm going to go for blue just to be nice and different with this one. Then on the wheels, well, I figure it's just going to be a case of going to sports chrome and just finding something that looks pretty, I guess. Actually, that one right there suits the MX-5 perfectly, but we need to make that a little bit smaller. And actually, I want to make them white as well. There we go. I think that looks all right. White? Is that going to work? That might be a little bit too much, actually. Do you know what? Default's fine. It's better than the other ones. So let's get our tyres, make the wheels a little bit smaller. That might be too small, or that might be perfect. We don't know. So let's just go ahead and check this out. And we'll get a little bit of wheel size or wheel width going on so that fits a little bit better. I mean, this is not going to be like a drifty car just because we're going to get some like massive wheels. This is just going to be your typical Stance MX-5 or Stance Miata, as you call them in America. And then we'll just get a visual lowering. Whoop. Drop that down. That is going to be very low with these wheels. And we're going to bring the front track width in. Maybe a tiny bit of camber. And then on the rear, tiny bit of camber. And actually, we'll get that poking out. I think that's going to work. We definitely made the wheels a little bit too small, I'd say, if we wanted to get some flush Stance. But as a basic look, I think that works for what I set out to build. And there we go. There is our Stanced. Sort of Stanced. Not hardcore Stanced, but still definitely Stanced MX-5. But, well, I guess we should probably go ahead and make the racing build now, because it seems we've got the full kit. So let's build the next one. Okay, and here we are done with the second build, and I decided once again to go for another shade of blue, and I decided to match the same blue on the wheels as well, and I decided to actually just go for, I don't know why, but I just naturally want to go for this sort of like cambered look with the MX-5, because I think MX-5s are either like pure functional, just sort of like drift, you know, just like a cheap drift car, or it's sort of really fancy and proper show car, and so that's what I've decided to go for with most of these, to be honest. And there we have our second build done with the full BD kit and Stanced with these wheels, and I've also gone for the carbon fiber bonnet, and I've gone for the secondary color cage in here just to make it nice and dark so it's not sort of sticking out or anything like that. And also, I've just noticed that we also have the color stitched into the steering wheel, which is pretty nice as well. That is our second build done. I'm actually going to do one more build that is going to be completely unlike these two, because actually there wasn't too many options for parts. There's still a pretty sizable amount, but I want to try and make something that's completely different. So let's give it a try. Okay, hold the phone. I missed the front bumpers, didn't I? Because we started off with this one, and I went straight to the back, and then went down. And I missed the front. But I didn't think about it here, because I went for the full kit. But actually, of course, there are loads of different options for the front bumpers I completely missed. Oh, boy. Okay, right. There's no doubt there. I bet that there's going to be a lot of commenting on that one. Okay, so we have the stock front bumper. Then we have... okay, maybe we shouldn't have looked. This is the removed front bumper. I don't know what that's supposed to look like, but what the hell? That is just really weird. Okay, so we have the stock. Ignore the removed one, because that's ridiculous. Then we have the clean front lip spoiler, which just sort of smooths that whole bit out right there. Then we have the BD one that we had in the previous one. Then we have the little carbon sport splitter. We have the half cut. Then we have the half cut. Okay, now it makes a bit more sense. Now we've got the bash bar or something like that. Now it makes a little bit more sense. Okay, that one's okay-ish. Then we have this one in the right color. That's pretty cool. Then we have that one. Then we have the edged splitter. Oh, see, now that would have been cool on that one as well. Or that one. Interesting. Okay, so we have that one. Then we have the smooth splitter. Then we have the clean front lip and edged, and the clean front lip and smooth right there. Okay, so that's all the front bumpers. Now I can go ahead and resume this build. Yeah, I can't, how did I miss that? That was ridiculous. And here we are, done with our third and final build that is completely different to the other two. I wanted to make this one just not low. I wanted the wheels to poke out and be massive. And this has actually worked out really nicely because I think this looks pretty cool. So this is a Battle Car MX-5. I keep saying MX-5 because it looks so much like an MX-5. It's the Kawaii. It's sort of awkward to call it the Kawaii, even if it is quite cute. So this is the Battle Car version of the Anis Kawaii. We've gone for this front bumper that just has like the half front bumper and then these bits down the bottom. On the rear, it would have been nice if we had some sort of guards for the rear, but instead, I've just gone for the bumperless look, even if it is a little weird. I think with these wheels, it sort of makes up for it. I went for the titanium exhaust purely because I wanted to go for something that looked sort of dirty, old and used and burnt out, so that worked pretty nicely. Then we have this spoiler because for some reason, I just thought that worked. Then we've also gone for the roof rack. I've gone for the matching cage here in the olive drab. And then, of course, I've gone for these big, massive wheels, chunky tires, made them bigger, made them wider, poked them out, lifted the car. And that is how we are left with this. I want you guys to let me know in the comment section below which one of these is your favorite. What do you think about this car? Because I'm quite on the fence because, first of all, I love the idea of an MX-5 that is law-friendly and inside of GTA. But at the same time, I wished it didn't look so much like an MX-5 because it just looks like an MX-5 mod to me. Do you know what I'm saying? Anyone else feeling this, or do you think I'm being a little bit stupid? Let me know in the comment section below what you think. But that's going to be it for this video. Let me know what car you like, and I'm going to go ahead and drive this one away. I'll see you guys then, or next time. Goodbye! Okay, so I'm actually going to keep this as a bonus piece after this for anyone who's actually just watched the whole thing. This is like end of the video. Cuts. No, I'm not even editing this bit. Anything I fluff up or anything I say wrong, it's just whatever. I finished this build and suddenly thought it would be really nice if I had all the dirt and stuff for it just to make this look proper sort of battle car-y. It's a shame we didn't have any liveries and stuff to go with this. So I'm actually just going to go down to paint just quickly because I felt like that was going to finish off the build and I didn't really want to edit this in, so I'm just doing this afterwards instead. There we go, full dirt level, like that. It does have all the dirt available for this car. There we are, nice and muddy looking. All mud on the tires, mud on the sides. And I think now we just need a little bit of actual damage, I think. Just sort of like run this down here a little bit. There we go, that'll work. Although, actually the bonnet sticking up is probably not a great look, I'll be honest. God. Okay, yeah, I'm not editing any of this. This is going to be like any cut, whatever. Oh, that's made it all clean again. God damn it. Right, this is if I'm streaming. Just pretend this is me streaming so you see all the idiotic stuff. Paints down to dirt level. This is like the normal pace that I normally do stuff in when I'm not going crazy with the recording. And there we are. And yeah, should we just find some people and just get a bit of blood on this one? Maybe a little bit of damage going on. Is that going to work? I just don't want the bonnet to get broken because that made it look a little bit too rubbish. Maybe we can reverse. How's that going to like get some scrapes along the side? Something like that. Is that going to... Didn't even scrape it, really, did it? No. Oh, hello, cop. There we go. A bit of scraping. And a bit of scraping. It's not really doing much. And some blood. Give it some blood. There we go, that's more battle car. That's what we want. And you. And you. Yeah, that's better. And, okay, now just messed up the bonnet again. Right, okay, that's it for the final time. If you've actually just watched this whole little bit extra, well, you're awesome. And thank you very much. And also, just can I just say, seems when we're, like, on the record as finishing the video and just sort of spitballing at the end, thanks to everyone who's kept watching since... because I've been away for like a really long time. Some of you thought that I was in Japan for that whole time. I've actually been back from Japan for almost like 2 months now. Almost 2 months. Like 2 months ago, I was in Japan. I was actually in Tokyo at this point. Exactly 2 months ago as I record this video now, not when I upload it. And I just, I sort of got overwhelmed when I came back because I'd already taken a bit of a break before going. So I've actually had like 3 months off this year and I feel really bad about it. And yeah, I just sort of spiraled into this sort of depressive state where I just needed to sort of take time off. So for those of you that are watching now as an old time viewer, that you're coming back and still watching the videos, thank you so much for sticking with me. And also to anyone who's watching this, who perhaps this might be your first ever video and you're just for some reason still watching at this point, why you would care, I don't know. But thank you as well, because you are clearly amazing. And I really do appreciate it, even if I don't really express that as much as I should do on this channel. So there we go, guys. That is it. Thank you so much for sticking around. If you have actually watched this whole thing here, I need to give you guys a word to leave in the comments here. Facade. I'm sure that's been done before. I'm sure we had someone saying facade. Anyway, say facade in the comment section below if you have seen the whole thing. But yeah, there we go. That was a nice extended bit on the video. That wasn't intentional for sort of ad revenue or anything, genuinely honest. I didn't notice that before. The handling sort of goes weird when you drive through these hedges. Is that me? Or is that... No, it does. Oh, that's weird. Oh, wow. Okay, it was actually that steering I was not inputting at all. I'm just going to drive dead straight through those hedges, and you're going to see that it sort of... That is so cool. How have I never noticed that before? Okay, well, that's the end of the video for proper this time. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.